So, what's God doing in your life today? You know, the back set of pressure, somebody says something, it's in your spirit, the information is there. You're no longer concerned with how your brain, the technician of your brain, your mind is going to comprehend these things. You're going to allow the spirit of God to have her way. And it's about having her way of the ocean, of the stream, not the water coming out of the ocean, standing on the land and saying, I need to settle over here. I need to go to that tree because it's bigger and I'll have more opportunity there. No, it's about the way of the Lord. Okay, they didn't mess up. You know what I love about my Heavenly Father? When people come against me or try to correct me in a seeming godly way, but an ungodly context of mannerism and their spirit because of a judgmental execution of jealousy, well, it enters in and promotes me. I don't just get promoted because I serve Jesus well, because I say hallelujah nice, because I'm not afraid to raise my hands in church. No. It is the constructive criticism, it's the backlash, it's the satanic agenda, it's all these things that come out against me that work out for a greater good. So there were some people that came against me, and the Lord was like, well, because of that, I'm going to promote you. Because of that, I'm going to give you more wisdom. Amen. And I'm being so rapidly changed, transitioned by the Spirit of God, devoted purely to His Word, really, really, really coming out of my own. He says, cease from your own wisdom. So I'm ceasing from my own wisdom. Now, I didn't really know what that meant, because I was all about, well, I'm gonna read all these books, I'm gonna get all this information, I'm gonna watch Gaia, I'm gonna watch this computer, I'm gonna fast, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna. Now I'm ceasing from all that, and that's taking me past my own ability to accumulate God. And it's putting me in the order of His Word, His original intent, the wholeness of His will, and the 24 turn of His will. Not just to the right a little bit, the full turn of His will. I'm in that circle. I'm in that seat. I'm in that place. Because it wasn't about you connecting the whole universe together. It was about being in the place and the location and the time. In the upper room, if they wouldn't have went to the upper room, they're like, well, look, that's a bigger space. That'll be better for God. It'll be more organized. We'll have more luxury there. We have more money over here. It'll be more settled over here. That's a million and one good ideals to step out of where God told them to be. So I want to stay in that upper room of my life, not what seems like more money. I want to be able to take this in context and put it in the world and show us the systems of our life. I want to be in that place where God has me. Because you can think of a million and one good things, and they seem so good, and they'll take you right out of the promise of the now and there. Where God was going to release an atomic bomb of holiness. Where God was going to trigger these keys in your spirit. Because it's better to know who you are and how to attune to God's voice and be where He desires and live in full appreciation, full devotion, whatever nice words you want to use. You want to fully, let's use the word value. You don't just want to value one area of your life and hate the others. And we do this all the time without realizing it, without being. So I don't want to go to my job. Well, I value God for giving me this, but I'm not making enough money. But they do this. But so you're not entering into the wholeness of that value and the location that God has placed you. Oh, I thank God for this job, but I don't like when it rains. So you're trying to enter into the wholeness of the value where there's a currency, there's riches, there's Christ, there's power, there's the next dimension, there's promotion, but you step out of it because, oh, well, I don't like this. Oh, well, I love the wife God gives me, but she gets on my, I don't like when she yawns. I don't like when she puts this on. And so when we do that, we step out of the wholeness of that value in every aspect and department of it. So we don't get this capacity, this revenue, this stream, and this is how you possess more occupation in the spirit of your mind, your life, your joy, your energy, your power, your strength, every second of every minute, and you translate darkness into light. Okay. And I feel promoted. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. See, when you operate in love and not in head knowledge, see, head knowledge is going to be like, who are you? Who are you to tell me I'm wrong? What do you mean? I know this. I know that. That's head knowledge. But when you diminish that and you operate from the heart and you live for Christ, you live for God, you live in life and from your heart and you interpret from your heart, because the mind's always trying to, man, why, you can't tell me that. Who you think you is? What? The heart doesn't do that. The heart receives without judgment, without neglect, without trying to comprehend. The heart is just pure love. So when I operate from a heart level and I devote myself to that, everything that happens in life, every whatever you want to call it, circumstance, somebody was mean to me, somebody disrespect, the pureness of that fire in my heart, it will consume it. Like somebody did something, you're supposed to be mad, but when you operate from the heart level, it will make you love that person more for that, and it doesn't make sense to the mind. And so this is what I love about maturing in God. Woo! Okay. Now, there are many decisions you can make in one decision. And there are many wisdom keys in one key. And we can apply this to going to the corner store. We can apply this to walking into the building. We can apply this headset, this arsenal of revelation. See, it's a certain amount of wisdom that turns into a mindset, and then you enter into a state of revelation, and then you get the visitation, but God begins to really just sit on you. He really begins to just possess, he really begins to, himself is able to regulate inside of you now. You're no longer binding him by your thinking. So the regulation of his power, it's an effortless stream of just pure God. And it's almost too simple to believe. You mean all I have to do is this and I'll get all of this? All I have to do is put a seed there, water in it? If nobody knew about trees, if there were no trees on the earth, and I went and I had the wisdom of God and I told this man, look at this mustard seed. I'm gonna put it in your hand. If you plant it, it will grow 500 feet tall. It will extend past. You'd be like, there's no way, that's not even possible. Because you can't figure that out in your mind. I'm going to give you this little seed. If you put it there and you water it, it's going to extend. All the birds of the north and the east and the west are going to come to it. All the civilized. You'd be like, no way. But by faith, you do it. Okay? You know what goodness is coming to you. I don't care how holy you are. And man is not holy. It's the Holy Spirit inside of you that's holy. If any man says that he is without sin, he has deceived himself. It's the Holy Ghost inside of you, boy. It's Jesus inside of you, boy. That's it. That's why you say, I, Jeffrey, I, Thomas, I, Eric, has died and Christ lives. That's what the Bible says, right? Now, don't get me, gangster boy. So, with them circumstances, which are, see, I don't see circumstances, I see currents, and I don't see right, wrong, I see the ability to connect the union to the body and bride of Christ and bring them into my hemisphere. I don't care if you're a devil worshiper, if you're an atheist, if you get in my vicinity, I'm gonna bring you to Christ. Whether it's by the power of God, whether it's through the submission of God, whether it's through the revelation of God, whether it's through all these, I got 15 levels of power surrounding me. You can't deny this orb flow. Okay. What are we doing? I'm so excited. There's this excitement inside of me. You know, I believe God has to defeat your thinking, your human thinking. I believe God is on a mission to conquer your human mind. Because this thing up here, the carnal mind, not the mind of the spirit inside, within. This thing up here is so worldly. And God has to conquer it, arrest it, burn it up, whatever. But This is the fashion. And now that I cease from my own wisdom, it is a piece of another piece. Of another piece. Now this release inside of me, it's no longer judge. It no longer has a mind of judgmentalness. Well, that video was more powerful than the other. It no longer has a realm of comparison. And you know something. Yesterday I realized, and I want to talk about this. However, the Holy Spirit wants to talk about this. Like, I was at my other job, and this lady let somebody in when she wasn't supposed to, and there was a principality on him. There was a demon, but. I did, and I told her, why'd you do that? Why are you letting devils in? And I did the same thing at this job. And then there was this person at my other job. They allow him to stay there later. And that pisses me off because you're supposed to leave at a certain time. But I was doing the same thing at this job. But in a different way. So I had to sit back and realize. It really humbled me. And then this person was doing this. And I got onto them. But I was doing the same thing, but in a different way. So it's like, brother, but I love it now because the more you have an ability to receive rebuke because you understand the Bible, you understand that instruction is the pathway to life. You understand that when God loves you, he corrects you. You understand that his discipline is your discipleship. Well, now you rest in the assurance. And now, his rebuke no longer becomes raw, timid. It becomes sweet and oily and glorious when you get corrected, when you get rebuked, when you get slapped. So when you get there, it actually brings more pleasure to the Father. The Father. The Father. Okay? Because you receive instruction now. You receive rebuke. You immediately... In your mind, you don't start trying to argue. You immediately. So you have surpassed a carnal limitation. Now you've entered into the reception of the oil that is stored in that realm of knowledge of being rebuked or corrected. So now you begin to enter into these spheres and eat this manna and digest it. And you transform past this physical. You know, this physical. I got to ask myself. What am I still basing success off? If I'm basing success off 80% Jesus, or 80% of the God that I've devoted my life to, his word, but somewhere there's a 20% worldly way, it's going to influence, it's going to tie around all the other. So it's about breaking these cords off them before you go out and be successful. Because as long as you have this mindset of 80-20, it's going to be 80-20 no matter what you have. 80-20 no matter what you have. And it's always a continuum of you get more money, you buy a nicer car, you buy a bigger house, now you got more property, now you got to take care of more, now you got more people that want to come and live with you, now God is expecting more of you, now that money doesn't even belong to you. See, so you don't got to understand, you can actually be richer and have more off less than. Because if... You open up into the spectrum of wealth and you begin to take over. Well, God's going to use that to bring people into your life. And he's going to use you in a shepherdship power where you got to govern that and you got to provide for them. He's going to give you provision. Not just so you can go buy Gucci and Prada. He's going to give you provisional power. And he's going to, but this is the key where he's going to expect you. So there's more expectation in the more that is given. So if you can't even learn to fully be rich in the financial period of where you're at, in the finances you have now, and it's still all about you, you're going to grow in God. And if he gives you more, you're still going to have that self-defeating, evil, demonic, which you may not realize, and it's going to grow. See, if this is a sphere... And I have a dark way in me, and it fills that sphere. If God gives me a bigger sphere, it's going to be filled with greater darkness. The eye is the light. So seeing, the eye is seeing vision of the being of identity. Okay. And I'm so excited. I don't know where I'm at right now. I don't even know where I went. There is a spirit of jealousy that I can feel from. And I cut its head off. I tell you, I ain't even got a violent deal with this. This one is weak. You know how you get around weak devils and you're like, shh, come on. I ain't even gonna pull out my sword. I'm just gonna use my dagger on this one. if I even flinch, that devil gonna get his head chopped off. And that's good. No, I have such a hunger inside of me that wants more of God. But I have to give of myself. I have to give up myself. My tongue must be a sacrifice to the altar. I must come here and give of myself. And God has to stretch my mind. Now the Lord is breaking me out of my comfort zones. Like the places where I'm at, like he's expanding me. Peace. Remember, and I said this before, if I'm gonna drive to a certain location and it's 300 miles, I don't just drive from one to the 300 mile. I gotta go 1 mile, 2 mile, 3. So God has to take me location to location, expansion to expansion. And it's bigger than just, God, I wanna go over here and do this. No. You have to have a certain acquiring of knowledge. You have to have a certain way of order. If you don't know how this works, if you don't know a science lab and the chemicals and the procedures and the safety zones, then you're gonna go into that lab and you're gonna set off a fire and it's gonna explode all these valuable chemicals that people have been searching the earth and world for. That's why when you don't value every step of your Heavenly Father, if you don't learn to appreciate how He does it, what He says, His measurement, you're gonna explode some things. You're gonna explode your life. And it's very dangerous. Because God can give you this 17-story house, but if you don't know how to manage it, it's gonna leak, frogs are gonna get in it, a fire's gonna set it off, and you know what I'm saying? So God can give you something so big, but because you have no understanding, no value, no learning, no discernment, you'll turn it into a massive mess. And now you got 15 feet demon, and now you got a whole entire army of snakes. Not just if you was living in a little house and you had like a little pest or a little pile of demons. Now you got them. So what I'm saying. And I'm grateful. I'm grateful. I gotta give it all I got before I go inside to this sanctuary. They're waiting for me. God has me in this place though where there's like no other place. Like there's no other place. There's no, like, He has me in this sphere, this chamber, and there's no other. The only way, and I love it because the only way I can be successful is He is my successful. If I wanna travel, like I'm getting to a point, the only way I can travel, He is the location. He is the paradise. He is the heavens. And He's changing my mind to actually see that. And it's really, it's causing me to be so just unworldly. And you know, I'm stepping into this paradigm. I'm stepping into this place. And I don't know. I just know it's raining right now. I know I got God with me. And I'm just thankful. I'm making more money than ever, and that's cool. I have the easiest job in the world, and that's cool. I'm my own boss, that's cool. You know, I'm in this sacred place with my Father. That's cool. And I honestly don't even know. Like, I've never, like, life, if you're really gonna walk, I believe so many people walk in a comfort zone. Pastors, prophets, preachers, and I'm just being honest. I'm gonna stop explaining myself. I think I'd be explaining myself too much, so maybe I cut that off today. Because we don't wanna be wrong. We don't wanna say nothing wrong. But we attune our attention to what people are saying. And we make our ideals and we profit. And then we even consider what God said based off the profit we're gonna make. Or there's more profit over here. Why would we do that? But I wanna get to that place where none of that even matters. None of that even matters. The only meaning in life that I can find is through Christ. The only place of assurance I can get to is in Christ. Jesus. I had to stop feeling to start knowing. Because I've been in ministry, I've done so many things where I didn't even really feel God's presence, but I had to stop feeling to start knowing. And as I begin to just go in this faith realm and God begin to build structures there and keep me there, now I can supercharge every obstacle in my life, every day, every moment, no matter what I go through, by faith and faith alone. I no longer need a text message from my emotions telling me, oh, it's okay. I no longer need certain things that other people depend on. By faith, I'm just like a bull in the spirit and I just ram through a thing. And I get, I may not know everything, but I break through. I'm really loving it. All right, it's cold up in here, I like that. And, you know, God is doing this more and more to me. He has me in a process, and his hands, the hand of God, is doing this to me. And it is diminishing every twist, plot, way, chord, slight direction of carnality. And it is purely launching me into his light, where all I'm seeing is purity, holiness, righteousness. Now, the eyes have attuned to me. See, the secret of dedication causes the eyes of the observers that are looking for a thing, that are in the mission, the ministry, to come forward to you. This is a secret hidden power. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Now my phone screen is all green, I don't know why. It's probably hard to handle all this power. What time is it? All right, we still got a couple minutes. I'm learning how to be wise in smaller departments and get more equilibriums of God in greater spectrums. Because I could go like this, but be unwise. And even though I seemed bigger, I got less. And I could be filled with the wisdom of God here and get high insight. Amen? Now, I believe there was a high note and a lowness I had to attune to, equalize. Because God's voice, it's very musical. When you can understand sound, frequency, and music, and we've wrote books about this on this channel. We've talked about so many. I'm in love with this channel because we have wrote so many books. We, through the Holy Spirit and the Holy Spirit alone and the wisdom of God alone and his word, by his power and his might, we have wrote books here, audio books. We have cassettes here. We have tapes here about everything, about life, about health, about money, about sex, about everything. And I love it. It's like all these visions and prophecies and dreams that God were giving me, like there is an outward manifestation, but the wholeness of the wisdom of it is here. Because you can get a building in a business, but when you unmaterialize it and present it with all the wisdom, all the structures of wisdom, all the souls that are being set free, all the history, this is a historical, like, database here. And I'm so thankful because of the Holy Spirit, I have not given up on Jesus. It's not because Matthew. Matthew's not holy. It's the Holy Spirit and pure dependency on the queen, that it's the Holy Spirit. You understand? Nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing. Okay. Now we just broke through there. Because you just got to mention the name and the person going to show up. And the person going to see. You mention it to see. We always trying to be bigger than Jesus. We always trying to adi-da-di-ta-pari-si-ti-ko-sha-kas. You speak the, you see, what do you mean? You don't just, Jesus, you speak the name, the meaning of his substance, the recommendation of his power, the actuality of his position, the truth of his word, the devotion of his sacredness. You know, so you speak his name and the person manifest. Then the person gets to do the work. You ever play a video game and you have like a partner or like a summon partner, and when you call them or you call on them, they show up and they can start using their abilities and they can start doing what they do and help you out in the battle. But we put our hand like this on God and try to do everything. You gotta learn to let him. Like right now, I didn't create this rain. He's raining in the earth, watering the plants, getting me into the alignment of promotion, preparing a place for me. He's doing all these things. If I can stop trying to do it on my own and sit back and rest, I can see all that he's doing. And I can literally rest in the future instead of trying to build the present to get to the future. So I can actually go ahead in time, past when I get married, past when I have a ministry with 20 billion people, and I can actually eat and harvest there, plant there, because you know God's in your future. 50 million years down your life, God's already there. 20 trillion light years, you know the speed of light. We're not even in time no more. We're in light years. We're in the specter. We're in traveling. Because it's the tool of traveling, not you being mentally binded by a 24-hour clock. You step out of the clock. And because you have access to every place, every position in the heavens, because you're redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, you can go in your mind, in your future, in your feelings, in your pleasure, in your experience, and you got to step out of a level of wanting. You know, if we all lost our, and I don't want to say it like this, but if we all let go, if every human being let go of their jobs right now, and we all walked into this valley I'm looking at, every human being on earth, it would have never mattered how much money you had. If we all were standing in this valley right now, just with a white garment, some people black, we would look at each other and we would remember the only thing we'd remember, the identity, not how much money you had, but what you did with that money. It wouldn't have mattered your house. They would have remembered the times you neglected them. That would be the final stance of all that you ever did on earth. They'll remember, man, he was always telling me about Jesus. No matter what, he reached out to me. No matter what, he was always encouraging. That's the remembrance of what stands in time. So what you're that's what you need to chase. If you chase that, you will receive their wealth. You'll receive the blessing of their business. You'll receive their household. Stop worrying about money and stuff, okay? Chase that. That's what I'm saying myself. That's what I'm telling myself. God, fill my spirit. He was saying, don't ever on the forefront of your mind try to tell somebody why they're wrong when you neglected the voice of where they were coming from. Otherwise, through your carnality, so-called righteousness, you spit. And close your eyes from the revelation and impartation in a hidden manner of darkness and your soul captured. Now you holding on to darkness, don't even know how to let go. Okay. Right? Now I understand the audience of one was to give me an opening to receive such. I can grab, I can let go. A time to embrace, a time to refrain from embracing. There are timings. And in between these timings, there is a code. There's this fear, there's this power, there's this light, there's this word, there's this grape, there's this fruit, there's this eternal rejoicing, because it's the extension of God's word. A lot of times this is the extension of God's word, and we're supposed to be in the melody of it, but we stay over here and hold on to this. So when it comes to the timing of letting go from refraining a thing, a specific purpose, and the timing of God, we still do it because we like it so much, but it's a melody. And we got to learn to level it out if we're going to be on a plain path in our vision, our life, our career. You know, my career is serving God. My career isn't, oh, I got this job. My career is going where my Father sends me. Now, he's not going to send me to a people I'm not ready for, to a place I'm not ready for, to a position I'm not ready for. He's just not. I might want higher level, but he being God, who is perfect and all-knowing and all-wise, he's not going to send me to a place I'm not ready for. Now I can step out of his wheel, go try to promote myself, and it will only lead to misery, darkness, evil, pain, destruction, nothingness, suffering. That's it. Chaos. Outside of the will and order of God, nothing but chaos. I know that. I know that through trial and error over and 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 over again. God would tell me something, I'd be like, let's do it this way. God would say something, now let's try this way. And it just every time, it only left me in chaos. And then I said, Jesus, forgive me. I need you. I can't do this. And then boom, he would bring me back, heal me, restore me, put me back, elevate me, promote me, wash me, clean me, give me my money back, give me my success, give me my joy back. And then I would be like, let's do this again. Millions of times. That's why I love God, and I'm in this place where I've been through a lot. I don't want to say I've been through everything because I haven't. I don't want to get prideful, but I've been through so much. And I know what it's like to not obey the voice of Christ. I know what it's not like to live according to this. I know what it's like to live in disobedience, okay?